Surprise!
Surprise!
Gary made it!
Where's the cake and where's the pizza?
He's
sorry. Here. Soda?
No French. Cake?
I know, that's
I'm
it.
I'm starving.
All right, guys, Paisteboy here, and we've got the whole crew here. Me, my brother Mark, Shag, Gary, Parker, and we are going to finish up Mark's Blair Morgan sled here. So let's see where we are at this point.
Okay, here's Mark worked on his motor mount a little bit and straightened it out.
It's good as new. That
you have to
one,
work
yes. We just got to put the bolt back in it, and we're good
back.
To go. Just kidding. We're replacing it with this.
Gary's asking this for chips and dip. I told him he has to actually do some work before he gets anything and put that coke back in the fridge.
We've been, Shag and I have been sitting here for an hour and 20 minutes.
Does anyone want freezing. Any snacks? Yeah, we have multiple varieties.
Oh,
wait,
my God,
oh, are
nice.
Those freaking kicks?
Whatever happened to the blacks?
It's basically a torque stopper, and it mounts to the frame.
We'll show you when we put it back
this
on.
This is the one off of a sled that I had that we
So it's good as new. We just might clean it up a little bit, but it's in perfect condition. So essentially, Mark went back and got the grade 9 bolts, Mark?
No, eight. I went back and got nothing because they didn't have them.
Oh, perfect.
Watch out.
Okay, so we'll edit this out. We're putting the same bolts back in.
Do you think grade 5 are enough for the starter?
Yeah, I think so. Sure.
Yeah?
Yeah, as long as it's not a 2.
Grade 8.
What does he get? What do you have?
They're 5s.
Those aren't 5s?
Yeah, they are.
What
they're 8.8s.
Do you know what comes, they come with?
8.8s or 5s.
That's supposed to be equivalent to a 5.
Yeah. All right, so the starter is fully mounted.
Do you have the old
and so we're good. We're good with that. And
I have no idea where that is.
What's next?
You're next.
What do you think, Gary? You got a half a coke in you now.
You're the one who brought it up. Make...
I got an idea.
A good coat of fire.
Gasoline.
Let's hook it up to the truck and we'll run it into a tree, and then we'll make an insurance claim.
I have to re-up
the insurance.
You can
get a 2004.
Yeah. Right. And a half. 1 year newer.
Dude, look at this guy. Top shelf.
Listen,
look
at the
coke galore.
Freaking loaded up on supplies.
What's going on in there?
I'm just looking it over for problems.
Gary's the inspector. He'll find it all.
I mean, like jack shaft bearing. Check the drive shaft bearing whether you're at it. Grease that. Look for stuff that's been rubbing.
Exactly.
You got it the
right way. So Gary goes through sleds with a fine-tooth comb when he's looking to buy them or whatever, or repair them, because that's the best time. And you catch a lot of stuff that it might have been a problem in the near future. So what do you suggest? Grease up.
Well, the drive shaft bearing should be greased right there, and I'd probably even check it underneath to see if there's any play in it.
Yeah, good idea.
Who knows if that's, you know, he's probably never greased that.
The Zerk is clogged, probably.
What's that?
The fitting, grease fitting for the drive shaft.
Okay.
Yeah, a little grease.
Red Loctite, they're like notorious for falling out.
They even make like
a special washer, which I think those might be the right ones. Nordlock. It's like supposed to lock the thing from backing out.
They're notorious for falling out. Keep a spare.
So Mark was saying that He might have one bolt for the wide pipe that's not in the greatest. Yeah, head is a little wobbly. They're a little sloppy. Yeah. Gary's like, hold on. Let me check my coat in the truck.
No, he says, let me go get one. I need to go home. No, I'm not one in my jacket.
Right? Look at the freaking man. He's always got stairs. He's got everything with him.
It's been in this pocket probably for like
5 years.
Or more.
Right? Since you had that 06.
Would have been when I wore this jacket riding.
For that 06.
Oh, that's a long time ago.
05, I mean.
Yeah, so essentially, Gary's the most prepared. He's always got something.
Oh, that was after that.
He brings extra belts for fellow riders and everything.
Huh?
Look at this.
See, but
man, he's got it.
This one has, red Loctite on it and some blue.
This one's got blue. It probably looks like a little red.
Look, red and blue.
Yeah, that's how this one is.
All right, we're going to get red Loctite. We're going to red Loctite everything. Right, Shag?
This one sounds good.
Yep. Okay, so Parker put the Y-pipe on. We used red Loctite now. And did you also red lock tight the starter bolts?
Yeah.
Okay, so we pulled those starter bolts back out and used red lock tight on those too. Because I guess a couple of you guys mentioned that in the last video, and Gary also suggested it, that he does that as well. So figure better safe than sorry. We don't need anything falling apart. So there's that. We're almost ready to stick it back in. We got Shag over there with the Scuncy steamer. He's spit shining this sucker. And Gary is taking the tape off of the wiring harness or whatever the wiring
for the battery. It's a positive cable for the starter.
Right. Because when the starter wasn't in use, Mark put some tape on it and stuff just to keep it, you know, clean and dry. Look at that, spotless. Shag with the town. The Scuncy steamer here. So, what do you got here, the boots?
Yeah, they're car boots. Great shape.
Nice. No cracks?
No cracks, no nothing.
Nice, that's good.
Except for that one slice.
Yeah, that's okay, but though. You can put a little chewing gum on that.
Supposed to have some ventilation.
Yeah, we're good.
Yeah, no, they're in really nice shape. They really are.
Definitely got to have coffee. This is my fuel right here. Keeps me going.
All right, so Gary just went out to his truck to grab all his stuff so we could do the leak down test on this engine. So we're going to see if this thing is holding pressure or not. Oh. They also call it a decay test or something. So we did a video of this, but Gary and I probably about 5 or 6, maybe even more, probably 7 years ago or something at his house on one of his sleds. I'll put the link to that at the end of this video if you want to check out that video where it specifically just went over a leak down test. But so here he is, he's back, he's got the stuff. We'll hook it up to the motor and see how it turns out.
So let's see what you got there, Gary.
Scary gear.
Okay, so we got some PVC with a valve stem on it, we got the other one with a pressure gauge on it, and then we've got this rubber kind of sealer thing that this will cover the Y-pipe exhaust, like, right?
100 pounds or something.
All right, so we'll show you how that all goes on. We'll do a little test, and we'll see if she's holding pressure. Okay.
Fucking killing me.
Quiet out of set! Okay, so Gary went ahead, and he put the...
the butt plug in?
Yeah, the plug on the Y-pipe. All right, Gary's going to... take the clamps off of those boots, and then we're going
to... supposed to be intimidated?
Well, you don't have to take them off. Just got to loosen them.
Yeah.
Yeah. And put the PVC in.
The karate chop.
You're doing it wrong.
This one has the gauge. Maybe you should put the gauge over here so you can read it easier, maybe.
Parker, we need something to plug that pulse line from the case.
Yeah.
We got anything? Here, Parker, spit on this so we can put it in the hole.
What's up?
Did you bring a little fuel line or no?
Yeah, I brought some if we need it.
So this is Gary's little homemade leak down test kit here, and he's had it, and we've used it, and it works pretty good.
Well, you got that clear hose? I think that might be too big, but let's see what you got. That clear hose you had.
I want you to grab some hose.
I'll be back. I gotta go downtown.
You like
that? Yeah, I like that one.
Yeah. It's perfect.
That'll work. We don't have a cap, so we're gonna have to plug this.
Put a bolt in there?
Yeah, or just a screwdriver.
Either you put something in this, or you just pinch this line.
Cut it.
All right, so we put a bolt in here, and Gary's pumping up the pressure.
What do we put, 5 pounds?
Yeah, 5 pounds.
And how long is it supposed to hold it for?
It's been a while. There, you're there.
Right there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, 5.
It's at 5. All right, so get a stopwatch going. Oh, it's dropping.
It's dropping somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
Right here.
Yeah, okay, so that's not sealed.
Okay, we're going to try it again. We put this clamp on there instead of that bolt. Right there.
Right there?
Yep.
You like that?
It's perfect.
It's dropping.
Okay. No, it's not.
Now you could pull the... thing off the valve stem.
There. Now okay. It's set.
And that's what we've got.
So how long
set a timer for 10 minutes. So let's get a good, real clear shot.
No, it hasn't moved.
All right, so It's been, I don't know, a few minutes, and we have lost a pound, but we don't know if it's coming out of one of the points where we've, you know, where we don't know where it's coming, where it's leaking from, so. It's almost down to 4 pounds. You see any evidence?
No.
It's probably leaking from this clamp right here.
Think?
I mean, it could also be coming out of here.
Well, I tried spraying that, but...
It's hard to tell. Gary's got an extra clamp.
Could be coming from anywhere.
Can you call it back up?
Try it.
Redneck car stunts.
All right, so... We're seeing here. We'll time that again.
Back up to 5?
Yeah.
I don't think it's leaking though.
Yeah, this. Right here.
Here?
Where?
It's bubbling.
Oh yeah, there it is.
Where?
Ooh, right at the, maybe yeah. You just gotta tighten it up. Can you see that? Okay, so it looks like it's leaking right behind that bolt. So we have to figure out how to seal that up.
Is it going down on the gauge?
Yeah, it's 1/2 pound down.
Yeah, that's significant. We could see right there clearly it's leaking at the Y pipe, so we gotta fix that. That's where we're losing our pressure. We took care of the ones on this side, but we gotta get that sealed up. All right, so we've got it pretty much holding at 5 pounds here. There is an ever so slight leak there at the Y pipe connection, but I think we're good. It'll probably expand as the motor heats up. I mean, you're going to get leakage here anyway once you hook up the exhaust.
I mean, it's bare. I mean, what are we at now? We're still at 5 pounds, and it's been about 3 minutes.
Right. So I think we're good here. So
we did fix the leaks here.
Yep, those are tight.
Those stopped, and now
right,
it's just
you
that
definitely
little...
don't want air leakage there, and we don't think we're good.
Yeah.
Right? What do you think? What's the verdict, Gary?
It should be fine.
Okay. Shag, you get your approval?
Sounds great.
All right. Parker?
Get that thing in.
You in? You good?
All right.
All right. We're going to stab that.
What? It'll do because it's not right. My slot if it blows up.
Oh, we lost it. It's gone. All right. We're good. All right. So Mark just put that new motor stabilizing mechanism in. Parker had an extra one on that carcass, so we replaced that. We're gonna finish bolting that in and be in good shape. So Parker's doing the final hand torquing. Not twerking, he's torquing.
Pipe.
Watch your hands.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it's gonna fit.
No. With the Y pipe?
I don't think that's fitting. I don't think so either. You took it the Y pipe no. out?
I took yes. the Y pipe off to get it out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think that's fitting at all.
Yeah, I don't think so either. That was Gary's idea. Yeah, we're gonna have to take it off.
Alright, so we're gonna remove the Y pipe because we just can't get the engine back in with the Y pipe on. Parker thought that would be the case because he took it out. So we're going to drop the pump and Mark,
get
what happened?
I just got shocked.
By what?
From static from taking off my coat and I touched the metal.
So Shag's cleaning up Mark's garage clean door. That's about 15, 16, 16 years of smoke. Nice. You're quite the artist.
Thanks.
All right, so Parker took the Y pipe off so we can get this motor back in. Hopefully the starter doesn't interfere, but we're giving it a shot. It's halfway in. And we pulled the plugs too.
Pick up.
There.
That's what's catching right there.
Yeah.
All right, so this is a continuation of day three. It's technically day four, but we're going to put this into part three. And we got just Parker and Mark here today because Gary and Shag are home. So, and the weather sucks. It's sleeting and everything's freezing. The roads are crappy, and they probably just didn't want to get up and leave the house. But I'll show you the progress at this point. We had to stop a little early yesterday.
Okay, so we've kind of got the motor like in place and
it's fully mounted.
Are you using a rope to hold your pants up?
Oh, it is. Oh yeah, you did. You put all the bolts in, right?
There's so four bolts in and they're all torqued down.
Yep.
We replaced all the lines.
We replaced a bunch of the fuel lines and the oil line. And so essentially we did have to remove the Y pipe and the one rave over here. Because we just couldn't get the motor back in there with the starter on it and stuff, so we figured it was easier to take the white pipe back off than the starter. But
the whip.
Long story short, so Parker's been working on that white pipe, and we also pulled the plugs when we were putting the motor back in because
we can't forget to tighten those.
Yep, and then got the new motor. Stabilizer, whatever you want to call that thing, in place. So we're working here. We're gonna get this thing finished up. So there's the front view.
This is the fourth time we've had this Y pipe off.
Yeah,
something like that. Fortunately.
All right, I'm just gonna give you a quick clip of what's going on over here with the weather. It's like sleeting, and this stuff was like freezing to the vehicles. It's just straight up nasty. So I got my truck here, and then my trailer is over there because I keep it here at Mark's house. It's just easier. Got the new tires from last year, but this is what it looks like. There's not really much yet, but by tomorrow night, it's supposed to be pretty good. I don't know if we're going to be able to test ride the sled once we get the motor back in it. But at the very least, we'll get it running. So I just wanted to show you what it's looking like over here in Western New York. All right, so Parker has the motor mounted, the recoil connected. So that's fully intact. Yep, so it's got compression. We're gonna actually do a compression test here in a minute. But I think we should hook up the other rave valve, hook up the exhaust, and we're in good shape here. Obviously, we have both clutches to put on. We're gonna grease that Zerk on the where the speedo and the
We're gonna do the
drive.
We're gonna do the jack shaft, and then we're gonna do the speedo bearing.
Yep.
And obviously the other side in the chain case.
So. Right. So that starter is it's coming along good. Obviously, we got the carbs and the air box and all that to hook up. Some more hoses. We got the antifreeze hose hooked up there. We probably got to put some more fluid in it, antifreeze. But it's coming along nicely, so we'll pick back up when we get a little further.
Yeah. I'm not plugging in that.
Okay, so we're going to do a quick compression test here. So, Mark's pulling it.
Oh. Yeah, but keep going. See what it'll go to. Yeah, that's about it.
What do we got there? Let me see it.
130?
Okay, that's
good.
Come on. So one cylinder, 130. We'll check the other side. All right, so we're testing the... Ooh. It's got some good compression here.
Good.
About 135.
Yeah.
Good. We got compression on both. Good compression.
Yeah. And there's I guess it's better if they're the same.
Yeah.
The other one was slightly lower.
There's a percentage that they can be different. I don't know off the top of my head. Every motor is set for different tolerances.
Right.
But fine.
It doesn't make a difference. It's also dry. Nothing's going through them.
Well, yeah. Also, this isn't an accurate reading because you're supposed to heat the engine up.
Right.
And that's supposed to get hot before you even compression test it. These motors don't run high compression because you're constant steady RPMs, where like some like the race sleds are they're all high compression because it's just like you're low on hit on and you're not you don't see those guys on the racetrack. It's like over jumping, they're not holding it in the air and stuff like that. So
right, cool.
Probably clean those clutches up with a Scotch Brite.
Did you check?
All right, we're gonna check for spark here. Hey, we have a visitor.
Who the hell said you can come here?
What's up?
And you're gonna trust him to plow for you?
Dude, you got an engine to rebuild. What are you doing here?
What's that?
How you doing?
Here.
What's up?
What's happening? All right, so we're trying to do a check for spark here. So what are you doing today?
You all right? Oh, I just had to drop the skid steer off the lot.
Oh, okay, cool.
Spark? Check the other side.
All right, we gotta check the other one.
God.
Yep. All right, so it looks like we got spark in both. We're good. All right, so we got the carbs are pretty much mounted. We got a few more connections to make there. And spark plugs are connected. Well, one of them is, so we're gonna keep going here. Okay, so Parker has the two carbs hooked up, the choke and everything. We got to put on the air box, the pipe in the can, and the clutches. But we're just about there. But he wants to start it up before we get everything
obviously
fully buttoned up, right?
Obviously, like, put the pipe, kind of mock it up. Just
yeah.
I want
to
start.
You don't need the clutch on it to start it.
I want to start it and then have to take stuff back off.
So let's go ahead and we'll put the can, the pipe in the can on, and we'll try it out. Here we go. We got somebody out here. Ooh. Don't even know who this is, but if he comes back, we're going to get him again. Oh, they got a freaking four-wheeler out there, too. Thought it was a car. We're alrighty then. We're putting some fluid there, topping her off. Because obviously when you pull the motor, you're going to lose some fluid. So we're going to do a little quick start here in a minute.
Attempt, yeah.
So
yeah, but we can't let it run long.
No. We're just going to get it, see if she fires up. And then we're going to finish the last few steps. We are just going to do a quick test start here, just real quick, just to make sure it's going to run. And if it does, then we will put all the rest of the bits and pieces on, and we should be good.
Do we need to put the jumper on it?
All right, here we go. We're
try it without the jumper. Okay. There's no battery in it. Ooh. It did fire though.
Yeah, it did, because I saw the light start opening up on
Could be just weak though.
That's fine.
That engine's got some compression, huh, Parker?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. Wow. Good enough?
Good enough.
Yeah.
All right.
Man.
Sweet. All right. So, fiber. All right, so we got it running.
There's no gas in the line, so we just threw a little down the cylinder just to make sure it would fire.
Just to get it to fire. Yep.
And
because we're not going to want to try starting it with the full start when we want to run it.
Yeah.
So we'll get the starter finished.
All right, guys. Well, that's going to wrap it up. I know the engine isn't completely fully, you know, clutches and all that hooked up, but it is in running order. So we're going to call that done. And you will obviously see it in future video really soon. So I want to thank you for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up.
Go buy some hats.
Yeah, buy a Paisteboy hat. Like me on Facebook. You'll check the links in the description. I do have an Amazon affiliate page where you can get supplies and stuff like that if you need them. I make a little bit of money off that, so that would be greatly appreciated. Let's thank Parker for all his hard work on Mark's sled past few days, and Ryan Griffin here for showing up, and Gary and Shag for their appearance yesterday.
Moral support.
Yes.
Not really support, more criticizing us.
Yep. But we will see you in the next video, and we'll see you at Snowdio. We're going to do a meet and greet there on the Saturday the 14th, so I will let you know as that gets closer. Hopefully, take care.
What? Hopefully we get Ryan to come and one of our other buddies, Adam, and maybe we'll all get to ride there. So.
Yeah. Yes. So hopefully we'll have a bunch of guys up there, and we'll get to meet some of you guys. So we'll see you next time. Take care.